In this module, we'll be looking into the basic hardware and software requirements that we'll be needing throughout this course. So the very first thing that you will need is a wireless router. Basically, this router is what we'll be using throughout our testing activities. So in order to perform all the hacks that you will be doing, you'll need a test wireless router. The second thing that you will need is a Kali Linux machine. Kali Linux is basically used for hacking purposes because it has pre-installed hacking tools, so it becomes very, very easy to use. The third thing that you will need is a laptop with a packet injection capabilities. However, if you do not have a laptop with packet injection, you can even buy an external wireless adapter and it will work just fine. You can even use a desktop along with an external wireless adapter and it's just fine. There is no such requirement of a laptop. So if we look into each requirement individually, I'll be using Cisco E900 Wi-Fi router for our testing purposes throughout this course. It costs $40. However, you can even get a cheap $15 Wi-Fi router and it will do just fine. I'll be using a ASUS K55EM laptop which has a 3rd generation i7 and a 8GB RAM with a 2GB graphic card. However, this fast laptop is not necessary. You'll do just fine even with a 4GB RAM desktop or a laptop machine. For this course, I'll be using Kali Linux in a virtual environment. So you can use either VMware or VirtualBox to run your Kali Linux machine. We'll be discussing about this in upcoming modules. And obviously Kali Linux machine, this is what we'll be using for all our hacking purposes. This is our external wireless adapter. It costs just $15 and it is one of the cheapest adapter available in the market. The benefit of this is that you can use it even in the virtual environment. So let me minimize this presentation and let's look into the requirement in much more greater details. So I'll minimize the presentation and let's understand each requirement in greater detail. So one of the requirements is VMware or VirtualBox. So basically what a virtualization allows us to do is, it allows us to run multiple operating systems at once. So currently, I have a Windows 8.1 machine installed. And in order to run other machine simultaneously, I need a virtualization software. So here you can see, I'm running my Linux machine along with Windows machine together. And this is the reason why we need virtualization software. Now there are two main virtualization software available, which are VMware and VirtualBox. VMware has greater features, however, it is a paid one. VirtualBox, on the other hand, does the job, however, it is free. So depending on which version you want to use, it is fine. However, in the practical labs, I'll be using VMware. And let's go to the website. So it's virtualbox.org, and if you want to download it, go to the downloads section and you can download the respective version. VirtualBox is there for Windows, OS X, Linux as well as Solaris. So depending upon your architecture, you can download it. The one that I'll be using is VMware Workstation 10. It is much more better than VirtualBox, but as I said, you'll have to pay for it. So it's your choice on which one you want to use. You can even use the 30 days trial version in case you want to try it out. Now, as far as wireless adapter is concerned, I'll be using the TP-Link version. It's W722N, TLWN722N, and this is what I'll be using for my virtual machine. Now, many people ask, why do we need a wireless USB adapter? So, let me give you a simple example for this. I enable my Wi-Fi. And here you can see that I am able to see the available networks. Now the problem is these wireless connections are not available inside the virtual machine. So if you look over here, there are no wireless connections available over here. And this is a problem with virtualization. Directly, you cannot have wireless from the host machine, which is my Windows, inside the virtual machine. But the problem is, I have all my wireless hacking tools inside the virtual machine. So I need some way to have my wireless hardware connected inside this virtual machine. And this is the reason why we'll be using the TP-Link USB adapter. What it will do is, it will give me wireless access inside my Kali Linux machine. So here, what I'll do is, here you can see that there are no wireless connection over here. And what I'll do is, I'll attach my TP-Link adapter. And I connect to my virtual machine. Okay, I'll verify it once with lsusb command. And here you can see that the TP-Link wireless adapter is connected. So once again, if I'll search, you can see there are a lot of wireless connections over here. So now, when I'll run various commands related to wireless activities, you can see that they are executing dynamically. Without the TP-Link router, this thing is not possible. So throughout the lab, we'll be using my TP-Link router to perform various kind of practical sessions. It is a $15 USB adapter, so not very expensive, and I believe that everyone who really wants to learn wireless security can afford it. I'll come out of my VMware and let's look at our last requirement, which is the Kali Linux machine. So the website is kali.org/downloads. And there are two versions available. One is the Kali Linux 64-bit 1.0.9a, and one is the 32-bit 1.0.9a. I have not really tried things with 1.0.9 alpha version. I'll be using the 1.0.6 version throughout the practicals. And the last thing I wanted to show you is this Cisco Linksys router that I'll be using throughout the practical. It costs around rupees 2350. However, even if you buy a 800 rupees wireless router, it is well and fine. So I hope you'll get your practical lab ready, and we'll continue for our next lecture.